bees pollinate over 80% of the world's pollinated food crops. That amounts to nearly one-third of global food production. A world with fewer bees would be one with noticeably fewer plants, flowers, and food. And during the past 5 years, a worldwide reduction in bee health, sometimes resulting in hive collapse, has not only threatened the livelihood of many beekeepers, but even the agricultural industry as a whole. One of the main causes has been identified as the Varroa destructor mite. This 2 millimeter long parasite attaches itself to bees' bodies and sucks its liquids. In this way, the mite can weaken bees' immune systems and spread viruses throughout the hive.
Professor Aldag, would you please describe the impact that the Varroa mite has had on beekeepers in the beekeeping industry?
Well, I think the Varroa mite surely is a serious threat to the bees. It's a parasite that weakens the immune system of the bees, and so the bees get weaker and more sick.
Nicole, when bees' health comes under threat, what kind of consequences can we expect from that?
About one-third of the global harvest, which means many fruits, vegetables and seed crops, are depending on animal pollination. And whenever then it comes to the threat of honeybee health, it also can come to a threat of global food production.
In 2009, BASF Crop Protection and NOD Apiary Products announced a partnership to bring a solution to beekeepers that controlled the Varroa mite. Nicole, can you tell us more about this partnership?
When NOD contacted us and introduced us to their great product, Mite Away Quick Strip, we immediately understood that by supporting NOD in this work, we would really help the bees and the beekeepers.
David, can you explain more about the solution developed by NOD Apiary Products, which was aimed at enhancing bee health?
Certainly. It's called Mite Away Quick Strips, or we call it MAQS for short. What it is formic acid produced by BASF in a saccharide gel formulation. We had some technical barriers to overcome to have it properly wick off as a vapor into the beehives, and BASF technology provided the solution. It's called EcoFlex, which is a compostable plastic film. And working with the experts at BASF, we were able to overcome that barrier and bring this product to the marketplace, starting in North America.
Nicole, can you tell us a little bit more about the current status of the registration process?
As David mentioned, we already have a registration in the United States. In Europe, we conducted several studies in 2009 and 2010, mainly in France, but also in Germany and UK. We tested two formulations, and one formulation showed very promising results with a high efficacy and low side effects. And we will go ahead with this formulation. And we will submit a dossier in 2011 to the UK. And following that, we hope to get the strips available in the first countries in 2012.
You mentioned that this product is already on the market in North America. Could you tell us a little bit more about how these strips have helped beekeepers in those regions?
Certainly, the fact that it's easy to apply, that it's made up of organic materials that are simply compostable into the environment. They are comfortable with the efficacy that they're achieving. So we're seeing a very good response from the beekeepers. The other thing that I would like to mention is the response of the bees. The bees are brought into this equation. We actually work with the bees. We apply the treatment in the brood rearing area of the colony where the bees maintain the temperature and the humidity. They control the level of formic acid vapor in the hive by ventilation. So when the hive is opened up, the strip gets put on, the hive is closed, the bees immediately recognize that it's there and start controlling the level of formic acid through ventilating the hive.
While our companies are quite different in size and focus, what we absolutely share is our common values and the passion to protect honeybees and biodiversity.
BASF, the chemical company.